song Negative to Watch. We're going to play that. We're going to bring it right out. You guys have this.
But there are fans who come across who have been sort of dedicated ER fans, and very often I get people who are involved in the medical profession, albeit you know, as a nurse or doctors or you know, medical workers, psychologists, people who, when they were growing up, were really influenced by that show. And you know, I find it incredibly humbling because it's something that inspired them to go on and choose that very tough profession to dedicate themselves to. And it really is a vocation, I think. Anybody in any of those, whether it's the police, the fire brigade, hospital workers, I mean, that is a teachers, it's a vocation, because you're never remunerated in the way that you should be, or really recognized in the way that you should be. I mean, they're the ones that should be winning the Emmys and the Oscars, in my opinion. So I find it incredibly humbling, because we just acted it. We weren't it, we were pretending. And we had great fun pretending. I mean, I would leave the hospital. I'd leave the hospital thinking that I really could perform open heart surgery. So thank God I didn't ever pursue that. but it has been, it's been amazing to meet these people.
I do have a few more questions for Alex. If you aren't already lined up, we have a fair number of people lined up to ask questions. We want to give most of the time to you wonderful audience members who are here to see Alex to ask your questions. Now, speaking of Dr. Corday, and of course, I would be remiss if I didn't bring up River Song. There are so
Professor.
River Song. My apologies, Professor. As the son of a professor, I failed miserably. You have this wonderful laundry list at this point of take charge female characters who are not waiting for a man to give them permission to do what needs to be done. Mm. And it's one of the reasons that I think I speak for myself, at least, and I think many of us out here, why we love your work so much.
You know, it's very odd because when I was at drama school and I graduated from drama school, I never got to play the sort of the traditional ingenue roles. I mean, I did one or two, but I didn't sort of have that huge roster, or I certainly didn't complete my bucket list, of the Ophelias and Juliets and I could never understand why, because I would say, you know, I am kind of sensitive and shy, really. It's not like I'm just out there ball busting.
Wow.
I guess, you know, I'm tall, I'm strongly built, and the crazy thing is that in a way, it's a cliche to sort of just assume that you have to be sort of waif-like in order to play those ingenue roles, because it's about what's inside you. And you can be fragile inside, even though outwardly you might look strong and capable. But I never really got that opportunity. But I mean, to be perfectly honest, I'm not complaining. Because I have had some terrific roles, and I love playing women who have this strength, because women are strong.
Yeah.
And actually, maybe the sort of the ingenue roles where young women typically were always ended up being victims in some way, or is no longer the vision that we want to instill in young people, and maybe it's important that actually young women know that yes, we have every right to be as strong and as visible as men.
Yes.
So,
when you were a kid, I mean, did you have a particularly strong female role models, whether just people that you knew or people that you looked up to?
No, not really. I mean, my mother is a very strong character. Mm. I mean, she absolutely sort of held the household together. And my grandmother on my mother's side was also a very strong woman. She lost her husband at a young age, and she basically had to run a farm on her own with three small children. I come from a tradition of women who sort of pick themselves up and just do it, survive. And in fact, I did a series called Who Do You Think You Are? It's a British show. And I was invited to sort of go on that exploration of my ancestry. And oh my God! I don't want, if people haven't seen it, if they want to check it out, I don't want to say anything because that it's a massive spoiler. You literally, you know nothing. You are discovering on screen. So everything that I learned in the moment. And I think it shows on my face. But I realized that I have come from a line of extremely strong women going way back five generations. So keep it coming.
I've just got one more for you before we turn it over to these wonderful people. Now, you've worked with a few different doctors. How would you describe the difference in their personalities? I don't think it's fair for any of us to ask which her favorite is, because how could you answer?
I can't answer, because they're all the same person. They just come in different shapes and sizes.
That's right.
How would you say that working with David versus Matt versus Peter is their whether it's their performance style or just the way they are on the set?
It's quite difficult because in a way it's slightly unfair to judge David because I came onto the show when he had made the decision already that he was going to be leaving. And so I think there was, he was in a kind of like an internal process of kind of mourning in a way. I don't know whether he was aware that he was, but he had a very hard time saying goodbye to the show. He knew it was the right thing to do, but he was so emotionally connected to that role. And so there was a sort of, I don't even want to say an air of melancholy, but he was slightly distracted.
It was a period of transition.
It was a period of transition.
Yeah,
exactly. And I think also he genuinely didn't know who the hell I was. And of course, I thought it was just going to be a 2-episode story arc, and I died. And so, in a sense, there wasn't quite the same. It wasn't that there wasn't the commitment on my part, but I thought that, what's the point of really getting to know you, because I'm going to die, and that's that. Whereas with Matt, when I did that, we knew that there was going to be this long journey, and that River was going to be called upon every now and again along that journey. And that also was very new to the business in a way. I mean, David had already, he was already on his journey as an actor, whereas Matt was really sort of at the beginnings, as was Karen. And so it was sort of, they were desperate to sort of learn, ask questions, particularly also about the show. So there was an immediate kind of us all wanting to hold hands and go through this together. And then Arthur joined as well. And we had a great camaraderie. We really, it wasn't forced, it just happened. And it was fantastic, and it still is fantastic. I get so excited when I know that one of them is going to be at one of the conventions, because we just carry on. We carry on like we have done, we fill each other in with what's happening in our lives, and it's sort of just lovely, and I know that it's going to continue like that. With Peter, I was intimidated by meeting Peter, because I am a big fan of his. I loved his work on the show In the Thick of It. That's the sort of role that I've known him play in the past. This sort of really tightly wound, slightly aggressive, but acerbically funny man. And so I was a little nervous. But I met Peter when he was, he had finished the season, and he was at the end of having worked that whole year. And if you play the Doctor, you burn out, and you burn out really fast, because you are in every scene. You have no time to learn your lines for the next day, because you're it's just a sort of an ongoing. You've got to learn all of these words, this dialogue. But actually, quite frankly, no one can help you with, because it means no sense. And then you finish a day's work, and then you have to go home, and then you have to start learning the lines for the next day, and it's lots and lots of work. So you get burnt, and he was exhausted. Yes. He was absolutely shattered. At the same time, I think he was really relieved to play some comedy. And it was a fabulous ending to what had been a very dark year for for the Doctor, actually. So we had a lot of fun.
You got to start the next season with a guitar, so I think he got all of his wishes.
Yeah. Actually, he had his guitar already in the Christmas special.
Oh, that's right.
Yeah. I know, because he was playing it.
Well, we've got maybe some surprises in store, but for now, let's get to some audience questions. Let's start right over here.
Come on to the front. So I love you since ER, by the way. River Song Arc is arguably one of the most romantic sci-fi storylines, I think. Now, you had to do that with many different actors. Was there anything funny you had to do to really kind of create that exact same spark? Because they all changed, but you did not. You had the same passion towards the whole scenario. Was there anything kind of funny that joined you guys together?
I think Well, I think the truth is that, as I say, ultimately the Doctor is the same person. And so even though when there was the transition, even though I'm working with a different actor, I had to remind myself that as far as River's concerned, it's the same spirit. And like I say, it's the same person, just in different shapes and sizes. And so that, for me, was the through line. That was the consistency. It was just like, it doesn't matter who it is. Inside is the same person, and that's the person that she loves.
Yes.
And so when she comes to meet her second wife, it'll be the same.
Yes, right.
I mean, I think, as I say, there were things like with David, even though there was a sort of slight, it was a different energy with him, we would do things. A Catherine Tate was fantastic because she was just so, she's so funny and so cynical in a way, and just gets on with it. So we would do things like when we were waiting to for lighting to happen or for them to just change something, we'd sit and play cards. And there was always an ongoing card game, which was great. With Matt and Karen, it's just silly. They just mucked around all the time, kind of taking, doing impressions of each other, that sort of thing. And with Peter, he's much more of a sort of experienced actor. And so he would be more quiet and actually take his time in just preparing for the next scene. But that again was a lot to do with the fact that he was just exhausted and had to try and keep those lines in his head.
Yeah.
Have I answered your question? Well, of course it's a spoiler.
It's a teaser
that I'm throwing out to the BBC.
I know, right?
So what you're saying is that all these people with their social media accounts, they could potentially get onto their social media accounts.
Let's start that campaign.
Thank you. So come along, Pond. Give us a question.
Great role model for all young women and women, and I'm very excited to meet you today. My question was that, were you a Doctor Who fan before you auditioned for the role of River Song?
I was. I mean, if you are born and brought up in England, you just are a fan of Doctor Who. I mean, it's sort of almost part of your DNA.
You get your NHS card, you get your Doctor Who fan club.
Yeah, exactly, if you're British. It's just like, duh, everybody watches Doctor Who in England.
Yeah.
I mean, it's quite extraordinary. It's like watching the Queen's speech at Christmas. Everybody does it.
Mm-hmm.
So it wasn't even that I was asked if I wanted to be a fan.
Mm-hmm.
I had to be. and the lovely thing is, I'm doing alongside the actual television performances, I'm also working with Big Finish on the audio stories. I've just finished another box set of River Song's Diaries, so that's the third season. And I really get to time travel because I've just been working with Peter Davison, and I've worked in the past with Sylvester McCoy and with Paul McGann. So I mean, River really is going back in time and meeting her husband.
Yeah.
Oh my goodness! I mean, talk about different shapes and sizes. Some of
yeah.
them sort of like there's one there's one bit in the story, and this is not a spoiler, but because we're because it's we're doing audio, so you have to sort of create the energy and the atmosphere just through what's happening with your voice.
Mm-hmm.
And we're all in these glass booths, and we're in a sort of horseshoe shape, so we can all see each other while we're interacting with one another. And we have these cans on our ears, So we can hear ourselves and we can hear the others, and we have a microphone. And you know, there's one. There was one example where the doctor had fainted, and I had to sort of carry him or drag him. And so, you know, I'm standing going, ooh, 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 like this. And Peter Davison got so cross because he was like, I'm not that heavy. And then we do things like, you know, you have to kiss, and so you're going. I start laughing because I see other people, particularly when they're dying, you know, if they've got some massive slug in their body or something that's eating them from the inside, because that's obviously typically Doctor Who, how you die. And so you see these actors going, and I just lose it. I'm crying with laughter. I have to really pull myself together. But it is so much fun. It's fantastic. So I feel very blessed that we still have those as well to do.
Yeah.
Well, that's a very long answer to your very simple question.
But we're loving it, yes.
Yes, I'm gonna ask you a question. Uh-oh. This is a true or false question, okay? TARDIS and the Dalek have both been added to the Oxford English Dictionary.
Ooh.
True or false? You're right.
You jumped right to it.
You get banana.
Hey, I thought it was after.
I was wondering what was in the bag.
Who else can say they went to a convention and won a banana from River Song?
I know, right?
No one. Right over here.
Hello, Ms. Casey. Well, Professor Song, I forgot. I called you Mrs. yesterday during my photo op. Me, I'm a vet, and seeing you, I've been following you for the last 15 years, and you've always played a very strong woman, and I loved you as River Song. My question is to you, did you enjoy playing, I'm sorry to say, the psycho River Song when you tried to kill your husband, or when you were always trying to help your husband as the doctor?
Well, the truth is that, I mean, obviously, as an actor, it's so much fun when you play a baddie.
Yeah.
For sure. But when Stephen Moffat started to write that whole long storyline,
mm-hmm.
And when we were sitting on the beach, for example, at Lake Silencio, and we were filming that, I knew that I was Rory and Amy's daughter at that point, but I couldn't tell anyone. So I had that secret, and they knew that I had a secret at that point. So when we were all sitting having our sort of picnic on the beach, they were trying in between takes, trying to get me to reveal what was going on. But when we then shot the moment where the doctor got killed, I didn't know that was me killing him. I didn't know that was me in the spacesuit because there was somebody else doing it.
Obviously.
So Stephen hadn't told me that. And then it was only later, when we were in Utah, when they actually said to me, okay, you were going to be doing that and we were going to tell you to do it, but there were some photographers who had taken some pictures of us shooting, and they were so concerned that, and they put them online, and so the BBC was so concerned that if I was in a spacesuit shooting the doctor, it would get out and that whole story would be spoiled. So they didn't tell me, they kept it from me, and it was only then when we were back in Cardiff that we had to shoot that against the main screen. So, and then with the whole story, you know, of Melody, and you saw the different incarnations of River, again, I didn't know that was me until the last moment. And then, when I was able to be badass, then it was great.
Yeah. I love you when you were the, when you're the coolest river
song. I like stealing big diamonds in my cleavage. I am big diamonds.
I love hearing that in that part of River and going on. I love that in that role. As a strong woman, you're just an inspiration.
Oh, well, thank you so much. I really appreciate it. Okay, I'm going to ask you a question. Okay. So, there's a guy called Douglas Adams, and he wrote
42.
The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy. He also wrote scripts for Doctor Who. True or false?
True.
Ask the audience 50-50.
Yes.
True?
Yes! Oh look, she's coming up for her banana. She knows she'd get one. You're welcome.
Hello.
Hello.
I love River Song. She's one of my favorite strong female characters. I'm also a big music fan, so I was wondering if you had to make a badass theme song for River Song, what would it be?
What, like a badass theme song that's sort of like already out there?
Yeah.
Like if she were making an entrance like a wrestler or something?
Yeah.
Yeah.
God, I don't know. What do you think it should be?
Power by Little Mix.
What should it be?
Power by Little Mix.
Can you sing it?
Yeah.
Can you sing it? I don't know it. Yeah, exactly. Hey, listen. You don't know what surprises I've got for you guys. No, actually. I mean, I'm kind of trying to think.
What kind of music does River listen to, do you think?
Salsa.
Yeah, I can see it.
Exactly. Yes, it was the Daleks. And do you guys want to know what the title was?
What?
I'll tell you, so you can Google it. The title, hang on a minute, I've got to go to my notes. Here we go. The title was... Have I lost it? Amy, where? Oh no. Here we go, yes, here we go. No. This is No, I've got gap between windows, 33 inches. What? That's not the answer.
That's because that doesn't sound right.
The fish? No.
yeah, that's right.
Where's my, where is it? It's gone.
The single or the...
Yes, exactly.
The single?
Yes.
Dalek Christmas?
Dalek Christmas. Okay, there you go. No, it's all I want for Christmas is a Dalek.
Yes, all I want for
Christmas. All I want for Christmas is a Dalek. And it was released in the 1960s by the Go-Go's.
Wow.
So you can all check that out, Google it. Or maybe
probably
you might even
hear
it later. And you can come get your banana.
I like that Alex is so concerned with everyone's potassium intake.
That's right.
It's very important, it really is.
Listen, it's not the potassium. It's the banana.
There you go.
Hello.
Hello.
I was just wondering what you think River Song would think.